on-block hole LEP is the newest innovation enhancing and simplifying LEP. Key advantages are early establishment of a plane of dissection and more efficient identification and division of the anterior mucosal strip. The key differences are two. First, we start the dissection at the prostate apex distally, finding the capsule early. This facilitates enucleation with more use of blunt dissection. Secondly, we avoid the 12 o'clock incision while leaving the first, in this case the left lobe, incompletely enucleated and proceed with the contralateral side. This helps define the strip between the two defects along with the anterior tethers. Equipment includes the ProTouch 1470 diode laser, Richard Wolf 26 French laser resectoscope with the offset nephroscope and piranha morcellator. We begin with full inspection of prostate and bladder before starting the incision. The initial incision is made at 5 o'clock at the apex just proximal to the VIRU. We start with 40 watts of power, and in fact, all of the dissection near the apex is limited to 40 watts. As we move more proximally, we will increase that power to 65 watts, especially as we are nearing the bladder neck. One can already see that we are identifying prostatic capsule very early in the enucleation procedure from the apex. Finding this landmark early and remaining in that plane or space allows more blunt dissection and more judicious use of the laser energy. The ProTouch does an excellent job with achieving hemostasis with both the 40 and 65 watt settings. Certainly, we can also use more specialized settings for achieving hemostasis, such as super pulse at a much lower power or intermittent pulse. As we are working retrograde and proximally, we are also sweeping laterally to separate the BPH adenoma off of the lateral prostatic capsule. We will eventually attempt to go anteriorly and separate that plane as well. For now, we're going to continue that 5 o'clock incision and elevate the BPH adenoma off of the posterior capsule. One can see how combined use of extending the loop for blunt dissection along with The use of the laser energy to divide the fibrous bands facilitates this dissection. Coming up on that 5 o'clock incision more proximally, we are dividing that lateral lobe from the median lobe. The difference in the dissection is that the focus begins on the lateral lobe. Now we're beginning to identify the capsule near the bladder neck. We're going to divide the remaining BPH tissue between the median and lateral lobe down to the capsule. Now working more proximally and swinging laterally and eventually anteriorly to complete that lateral lobe enucleation and reach that anterior plane. Now we begin to enter through the bladder neck between the anterior prostate and the capsule. We'll widen this space bilaterally as far as possible. Although the anterior dissection does require additional skill and practice, this is critical to performing the en bloc enucleation. This can be mastered with some patience and perseverance. And once one can perform this procedure, it is much easier to do the entire procedure itself. The left lateral lobe is about 90% completed. And at any point now, we can move to the right lateral lobe. Next, we perform the 7 o'clock incision from the apex, identical to the 5 o'clock incision. There are some who do not perform the second incision and rather utilize the 5 o'clock incision, performing en bloc circumferentially, starting on the left and then moving underneath the median lobe and swinging to the right side. I still prefer to do bilateral incisions, simplifying that dissection somewhat. Once the 7 o'clock incision has been completed, attention will be turned back to the median lobe and we will complete the median lobe enucleation before completing the right lobe enucleation. We have now reached capsule near the bladder neck and almost completed that 7 o'clock lateral lobe incision. Median lobe enucleation begins now at the proximal virio, connecting the 5 and 7 o'clock defects through the mucosa down to the capsule through the BPH adenoma and working proximally. This is the traditional type of median lobe enucleation previously performed. back to completion of the right lateral lobe enucleation, working laterally but in that proper plane, utilizing both blunt and sharp dissection. Shortly, we will enter through the bladder neck and begin to free off the anterior prostate from the anterior capsule. Once this is done, at any point, we can move toward management of the mucosal strip. Now, with bilateral defects recognized, yet the BPH adenoma on the right and left are in the proper orientation, we can recognize the mucosal strip between both defects. We extend the laser We want to try to stay on the BPH adenoma and away from the urethral sphincter. The mucosal strip, in almost every case, seems to be much more substantial than one might imagine. As we begin to work more proximally, we're no longer in the mucosal strip, but are still dealing with some of the anterior prostatic capsular tethers. Once we are away from the sphincter, we can turn our power back up to 65 watts. But 40 watts does seem to work quite well in this area as well. Now the mucosal strip and all of the anterior tethers have been released. It is relatively straightforward to work circumferential around the both lateral lobes, finding the residual adhesions, and divide them in order to release both lateral lobes en bloc, adherent to one another from the 12 o'clock anterior commissure. Both lateral lobes now released into the bladder. Hemostasis is achieved, and whatever irregularities remain can be smoothed down before we begin to morcellate. Once we have adequate hemostasis, we hook up dual line irrigation and make sure the bladder is distended. We morcellate in the center of the bladder with the Richard Wolf 4.9 millimeter morcellator with the offset nephroscope. This was a 32 cc morcellated prostate volume.